Lee Jung-Jae, who plays Seoul, learned English for his role as Seoul in The Acolyte. Yes, Lee Jung-Jae, the South Korean actor best known for his role in the Western world, of course, in Squid Game, who now plays Seoul in The Acolyte series, sat down for an interview with Forbes, where he gets into some details on getting the role for Star Wars, it being his first Hollywood project, and even learning English for the role of Seoul. I want to read through this interview for you guys, and we'll talk a little bit about it at the end of the video. Here we go. Interviewer Regina Kim says, "The Acolyte is your first Hollywood project. How does it feel to make your Hollywood debut?" Jay: "Hollywood is a mecca for the entertainment business, so it feels very meaningful to have participated in a Hollywood project. I did think about what sort of Star Wars project I might want to get involved in, but I didn't know I'd actually get to appear in Star Wars like this, and I definitely didn't expect to be in a Jedi role. I feel very grateful to director Leslie Headland, Lucasfilm, and Disney for giving me such a huge opportunity." Kim: "What was the hardest part about playing Seoul?" Lee: "I'd have to say it was successfully pulling off the role of a Jedi. If you take, say, a film like Il-Mer, there's no history behind it. It's such a standalone work, so I can act freely according to my own imagination. But with Star Wars, it's a franchise with a 50-year history, and we've seen many other Jedis during that time, with a number of different actors playing them. So I had to think a lot about how this role and the series ties into the broader Star Wars saga, and also how to portray a Jedi in a way that's consistent with the Jedis from previous works, that's consistent with the image of the Jedi Order. But at the same time, there were also parts about Seoul that I had to make up on my own. So there were a lot of things I had to keep in mind when playing Seoul in order to successfully convey both aspects, both the traditional image of a Jedi and Seoul's individual personality simultaneously." Kim: "And I imagine it must have been even harder because you had to say all your lines in English." Lee: "Ah, yes, yes, of course." Kim: "I think you did a great job." Lee: "Thank you." Kim: "How are you able to learn English and get to that level in just 4 months? I was shocked." Lee: "Well, I did learn English a bit while in Korea, but for The Acolyte, I worked with 2 dialogue coaches and practiced a lot." Kim: "Seoul definitely seems like a character that would be difficult to portray. Is there anything you did in particular to make it easier to play Seoul?" Lee: "I wouldn't say I did anything in particular. Rather, director Leslie Headland and I talked a lot on set about how to make Seoul's character more multi-faced and three-dimensional. I also watched how Jedis were portrayed by different actors in previous Star Wars films and shows. As I mentioned before, it was most important for me to figure out how to simultaneously convey the image of a classic Jedi and the image of Seoul as a Jedi. Also, The Acolyte takes place before the other Star Wars shows and films, so that means that Seoul is from an older generation of Jedis. So I imagine that Seoul became a Jedi at a time when Jedi training was a bit less developed and formalized, and I thought that could translate into Seoul having a harder time controlling his human emotions. I thought it could seem more interesting if I were to express his emotions a bit more candidly. So when the situation called for Seoul to be friendly, I'd show him as being more open-friendly and warm-hearted. And when Seoul was feeling fear, I would try to express his fear more. But as a result, audiences have been saying that the Jedi seems to be rather different." Kim: "Yes, that's true, but I think it works very well for the show." Lee: "Thank you." Kim: "Do you have a role model or mentor in the Korean entertainment industry? Is there someone who you've looked up to and learned a lot from while building your acting career?" Lee: "There's a Korean actor named Ang Sung-ki, who's played a diverse range of characters, and he's portrayed each of them exponentially well. He's also one of the key figures responsible for the renaissance of Korean cinema. Off-screen, he has such a warm heart. His kind words and actions have touched a lot of people and brought them joy. So Ang Sung-ki is one of the role models that we younger actors want to emulate the most, both in terms of his on-screen acting and the kind of human being he is in real life." Kim: "And would you say you were able to take some of the things you learned from Ang Sung-ki and apply them to your Star Wars role? Did any of it help you with your role?" Lee: "Of course. I took inspiration from some of the warm-hearted and charismatic characters he played." Kim: "There's something that I've been really curious about. How is the production process for a Hollywood show different from that of a K-drama? Is there anything that felt surprising or completely unexpected while you were filming The Acolyte?" Lee: "Well, the production process in Korea and in Hollywood is pretty much the same. There are a lot of Korean creatives who have studied abroad and are now working on film and TV sets in Korea, so I think they've largely adopted the Hollywood system. So I'd say the filming process and atmosphere on set are almost the same. But what was really different was the fact that The Acolyte is a Star Wars show. A Star Wars set is really something else." Kim: "How so?" "Well, as I mentioned earlier, Star Wars content has a 50-year-long history, so the method of filming, CGI, sound, props, art, makeup, everything, has been developed over the last 50 years. I think no other system like it exists, even in Hollywood." Kim, I see. That makes sense. Is there any particular role you'd like to do next, whether it's for Hollywood or a K-drama? Lee, rather than a particular role, I'm planning to work on more film and TV projects in Korea and hope they'll be viewed by many international audiences as well. And if the opportunity arises again, I'd love to work on another project in the US. Kim, yay. I hope that happens. Kim, will there be a season 2 of The Acolyte? And if so, will we be seeing Saul again? Lee laughs. So far, there have only been 2 episodes released, with 6 more episodes still left to go. I guess this means the show will have to be a huge hit, right? I know the show is currently very popular here in the US. Lee, yes, I've heard that the viewership numbers are really high, and many critics have given the show positive reviews, which is encouraging for us. Kim, I've heard that the Star Wars franchise isn't very popular in Korea. Is that true? And if it is, might that change soon, given that you're starring in The Acolyte? Lee, actually, there are a lot of Star Wars fans in Korea. There are a whole lot more in the US. So compared to the US, the number might look small. We had The Acolyte premiere in Korea. A lot of Star Wars fans showed up, and they said they really enjoyed watching the first couple of episodes. Also, Korean audiences tend to like tight and fast-paced storytelling. Kim, wait, really? I feel like that's not the case when I watch some K-dramas. Lee, Koreans like a plot that is filled with many different emotions and subplots, and since The Acolyte fits that description, I think they'll enjoy this series. So there you have it. There is that interview with Lee Jung-Jae, where he gets into his time in Hollywood, with The Acolyte being his first Hollywood and US project, learning English for the role in just 4 short months with the use of 2 dialogue coaches and lots of practice, and just some other cool tidbits about his career, who he looks up to, and the process of filming a Star Wars show. Now, I found 2 big things really cool about this interview that he explained for us. One, of course, the title of the video is that he learned English for this role, which is very commendable. I respect that a lot. And honestly, watching The Acolyte thus far, you would have never guessed that he didn't know English 4 months prior to filming the show. Which, again, not too much to say on that. I just think that's really awesome, really commendable. And so far, Sol is 100% my favorite character from The Acolyte. Great performance from Jay, and I'm excited to see where his character goes in this series and hopefully in the future in other Star Wars projects. Now, the last big thing I took from this article is how he described preparing for this role, and it sounds like he really did a lot of studying up on it, which is great, and it shows. He said he watched a lot of Star Wars content leading up to it, he took notes of other Jedis from different eras, watched how they interacted, and how they hold themselves, and kind of found this happy medium between them, this era of Jedi, how he wanted to see the character, and how Leslie described the character to him, even making some things up on the fly, which again shows in his work. As I described Sol in my episode 1 and 2 review, he seems like a very calm and compassionate Jedi, almost like a mix of a Qui-Gon and Mace Windu with his wiseness, and seems to have this mental fortitude, but also this mental psyche that can kind of break, because as he worded it, this is a time where the Jedi aren't trained and developed as much as we have seen them in the prequels, and even how that training carried over into the original trilogy. This is about 80 years prior to the peak of the Jedi, so they are still learning a lot in how to train, how to carry themselves, and what the Jedi Order stands for. Which is what I've been saying this whole time when anybody has any criticisms about the Jedi or how the Jedi work in this series. This is the High Republic, this is a different era, and Jay seems to understand that, and I really respect that, and you can 100% see it in his character, and I think that's what makes it so intriguing. And it's really cool to hear what happened behind the scenes in order to make this character have such great intrigue. But yeah, those are just my quick thoughts on some of the highlights of that article. If you want to read it for yourself and see some of the images that go along with it, I'm going to link it down in the description below. That is all I have for now. I want to hear what you have to say about all the things mentioned in this article. What was your favorite part? Were you surprised that Lee Jung-Jae did not know English before starring in The Acolyte? And are you impressed with his performance thus far? Why or why not? I'm looking forward to reading those and responding to them in the coming days. And while you're at it, make sure to leave a like on the video and subscribe to the channel if you're new. Thank you so much for watching, and have a great day.